If there was one kingdom in all of Odyssey that absolutely everyone would agree is cursed, it would probably be Wooded Kingdom. Its troublesome tricks and back-to-back technical movement make it one of the biggest choke points for most people and can end up costing most not only a lot of time, but a lot of runs. So before we jump in, if you're not already and you've been enjoying the Odyssey content that we've been putting out so far, do consider hitting the subscribe button. There are at least like 50% of you guys that are watching these videos that aren't already. And I mean, if you're watching them and you want to see more of them, why not subscribe so they appear in your sub feed? Duh. And if you want to come and chat with me live, ask me any questions about Odyssey, or just talk to me about random stupid stuff, why not jump on over to my Twitch channel? I stream about 5 days a week, every single week, and we'd love to see you over there. So, before we actually get started, I should also probably gloss over the route we're going to be going over here in Wooded Kingdom, as there are, at this point in time, like 5,000 different wooded routes that people recommend, depending on where you're at skill level-wise. So, to streamline this video, as it's currently sitting at almost 4,000 words, and avoid confusion, we're just going to be focusing on one main route, Tree Route, with Spewitless. This is the most advanced route for Wooded Kingdom, isn't overly difficult, but also only really saves time when done properly. But at this point, if you're working to improve Wooded Kingdom, it's one of your options, so we might as well go over it. After we go over the main route, we'll also be going over a quick little backup route for if you miss Nutclip. This probably won't help a whole lot of people, as I imagine most people probably reset if they miss Nutclip, but as it's kind of recent and not a whole lot of people know about it, I feel like it's probably best to just bring it up, and if anyone needs it, it's there. So, once you're in Wooded and you've skipped through the beginning cutscene, hold up left on your analog stick and initiate a roll. Make sure to continue holding the roll button, which in my case is Y, throughout this whole movement, then shake to roll boost 4 times, then run into the rock. Make sure to move your camera towards the right as you move along to make things a little bit easier. If you continue holding the Y button the whole time, Mario should just instantly pick up the rock. Once you pick it up, make a direct line towards the bunny and jump to maintain your momentum. Then jump again and veer towards the right so you hit the bunny as soon as it hits its predetermined spot. Then instantly turn left and head towards the other rock. Jump on top of the big boulder, then tap B again to short hop forward, and as soon as you land, press and hold Y and continue moving in the same direction to break open the shiny rock, then of course jumping into the moon to collect it. After collecting the moon, dive and center the camera, then double jump, utilizing short button presses towards the bunny moon to collect that as well. Then, after collecting the moon, simply turn Mario around and dive towards the shop. Roll boost twice, and if you're low on coins, there are two hidden in these bushes here. Then as you're approaching the shop robot, stop your roll directly in front of it, then quickly into first person and press A to talk to him and grab the shop moon. We go into first person here, similar to why we go into first person in Cap Kingdom just before the bridge animation. When done properly, it can save a little bit of time as it skips a camera panning transition. Once you come out of the shop moon animation, start buffering a spin pound, adjust your camera to the left and up, then spin pound in this direction as soon as you gain control of Mario. Roll boost 3 times, or most of the time 2, as you won't really get a motion input, and begin a triple jump. Then cap dive towards the wall, dive onto Cappy, and reset your camera with a bumper button, wall jump off the wall, then cap throw and dive back towards the wall. Next up, we have a little bit of fancy movement, involving a pretty simple charade, or Shirane, or however the heck, bounce against the wall. This looks daunting and quite unforgiving, when in reality, this is probably the easiest one in the entire route, as long as you know where to land, as it's all about how far away from the wall you are. When you dive back on top of the waterfall, land in this bush right here. This is the perfect distance away from the wall, and is a really solid visual cue, as you can see it in a pinch. Then, simply spin pound at the apex of the spin pound, throw Cappy to the right towards the rock face, and basically instantly dive and neutral bounce into Cappy, then throw Cappy forward on top of the platform and dive. Don't worry, you honestly won't ever bonk here as long as you're in the positions I've shown. Then begin roll boosting towards the uproot, and once you're close enough, roll cancel into the uproot and throw Cappy again to capture. Walk off the platform as the uproot, and as explained in my Talk Drift video, boost off of the spawning pad to get Speedy Nut Boy. If you haven't seen that video already, I'll try my best to remember to link it in the description. If you're lucky, you might end up with both versions of Speedy Nut Boy, but really, this version alone is enough. If you do indeed get Speedy Nut Boy, hop your way over towards the tree. Normally you can fit in 2 big hops here. If you didn't, just simply walk. Jumping here will slow you down. Press the button on your controller, then shake to boost up to the first platform, then release the button on your controller as soon as you can to hop onto it. Do the same thing to the next platform, and of course the same thing to get up to the final platform. Then once you're on the top platform, simply press a button and shake into the nut to break it open and spawn in the moon. If you want to be extra fast here, make sure you break open the nut on the left hand side to save a fraction of a second on your next piece of movement. Once you've collected the moon, release the uproot towards the left. Then once you pass the tree, uncapture it and dive forwards. Continue roll boosting in the direction of the next nut moon, making sure to roll boost over this edge here so you can sneak another boost off this slightly raised piece of ground. Then stop rolling and simply begin running. Begin a triple jump by jumping up to the side of this platform before diving up top. You shouldn't have to cap dive here. If you are, it means you're not doing the movement correctly. Try your best to adjust it so a cap throw isn't necessary, as if you've been watching any of my PB analysis videos, you would know they are incredibly slow. Once you land on the floor, backflip, cap throw, and dive towards the camera pretty soon after. Then hold back forward on your analog stick, input an up throw, then shake to home it in, and dive up to the nut. Ideally, Cappy here will do some damage to the nut. Sometimes he can get stuck on top of the nut, sometimes he won't home into the nut. Doesn't really matter at the end of the day, it's only a minor time loss if you don't get it, but it is a fancy little time save if you do. As soon as you land on the floor, assuming that Cappy has done a piece of damage to the nut, jump into the nut, and turn Mario around. Then backflip and do your normal nut clip inputs. When done properly, this movement should have absolutely zero downtime. You shouldn't be delaying anything that you don't need to. You shouldn't be taking your time. This is an area of Wooded Kingdom that is pretty easy to speed up once you start getting comfortable with moving Mario at very fast speeds. And to be honest, when it does work, you feel like an absolute god. Now, nut clip movement. I have gone over this before in the past, but as that video is about as old as the dinosaur in Cascade Kingdom, let's get way more optimal with it here. Once you've clipped through, cap throw and dive behind Mario, or straight ahead, I guess. Swing the camera around, then cap throw and dive for this spot right here. Landing here will ensure the camera doesn't go all wonky and start spinning in wild directions when you backflip. Speaking of, as soon as you land, backflip. At the peak of the backflip, throw Cappy towards the up left position, or towards the rock wall, and dive into him. Then swing your analog stick more towards an upright position to compensate for the camera that does swing. Simply wall jump off the wall, then instantly throw Cappy back towards the hole in the rock wall and dive into it. As soon as you land, what I like to do is kind of just give the game like 0.2 seconds to let Mario reset his momentum, then hold up left and run towards the moon. Then as soon as you fall over the edge, hold back into the wall so you can instantly wall jump. Learning to control Mario with this much speed definitely takes a lot of time, a lot of patience, and a lot of practice, and it's gonna feel absolutely wild for a long time. But the more you do it, the more the timing makes sense, and the less you freak out while Mario is moving at 100 miles an hour. It is important to note here that I believe there is, you know, more than enough ways to continue Mario moving after diving without having to wait, but really, again, those save not really a whole lot of time, and to be honest, going for it in runs will probably just make you miss the moon, so it's probably not worth doing. Anyway, as I stated before in my nut clip route video, there is an invisible wall directly to the right of Mario, so you do have to fall slightly here before finally cap diving towards the right. When you do, neutral bounce, then cap stall against the rock wall before finally wall jumping and diving up top. If you realize you don't have enough height, you can chuck in a cap throw here to squeeze just a little bit more out, but ideally that shouldn't be happening. Once you're up, roll boost 4 times and head towards the ramp. Once you come out of the roll, what I then like to do is turn the camera towards the ramp and begin holding up on the analog stick so that when you come out of the roll, you can immediately start running into the ramp and then begin mashing the B button to jump up it. Once you get to the top, either jump at the peak of the ramp or side flip. Then cap dive to the left and hold towards the railing to wall jump off it. You don't want to cap stall here, that's obviously slow. Once you've jumped off the wall, cap dive and dive back towards it to get over the railing. Then buffer a spin pound forward towards the nut moon. Then once you come out of the roll, just before this line on the floor, begin a triple jump. Utilize small or medium sized hops to space out these jumps so your final triple happens on top of this railing, making sure it's simply a tap of the B button and not a full hold for the final jump, as we don't want a full height triple jump here, just enough to make the distance. Once you land on the section of the floor floor ahead of you, short hop again, and begin buffering a spin pound. Then as you land right on the edge, spin pound over the ledge to quickly break open the nut. Begin turning your camera around so you can see where you're about to go. Then of course, jumping into the moon to grab it just as it spawns. Once collected, buffer a spin pound and spin pound straight ahead. If you want to, you can try and do the roll cancel over the edge to get a little bit more horizontal distance, as I explained in my roll cancel tips video, but it is quite obnoxious to get consistently, so don't worry too much if you don't get it perfectly, it doesn't overly matter. Then of course, simply diving on top of the nut and spin pounding to instantly break it open before jumping into the moon and grabbing it as it spawns. Once you've grabbed the moon, turn around as Mario and dive, then long jump off the cliff. Delay for a bit, then cap dive, and dive onto the platform with the uproots. Roll boost twice, then roll cancel into the uproot, and throw Cappy again to capture it. Similar to the uproot before, you can try to get Speedy Nutboy off this spawning pad by pressing Y, then shake boosting, and jumping onto the flooring above. Then again, to push up the rising platform, then pressing Y and shaking again to push up the rising platform, before releasing to continue towards the left. Then once again, press Y and shake to break open these first set of blocks, then release to hop to the right once you're up top. Simply press Y to hop up again, before pressing Y and shaking to break the nut open. Then release the Y button just before collecting the moon, so you're already falling by the time you do collect it. Then simply fall to the left and fall through the blocks you broke open before. As you're falling as the uproot, once you've fallen past the wall that's directly to your right, uncapture the uproot, fall towards the right as Mario briefly, so you can perfectly space a dive onto the little ledge. During the dive, buffer a spin pound, then as soon as you land, spin pound over the edge and hold down on your analog stick. Once you hit the ground, boost, then roll cancel towards the left to roll cancel out of the area you're in. Once you're out, instantly input a motion shake to get Cappy back. If you don't do this, you'll fall into deep woods here or you'll die. Once you've got Cappy back, cap dive and dive again onto the platform, then roll boost twice. And then next up is the movement to the nut around the corner. Everyone has a slightly different way of doing this, so I'll just go over what I choose to do. It doesn't overly matter as long as your lines are good. Once you come out of the second roll boost, jump, then double jump, avoiding the poison. And most people do a short hop triple jump here, but I don't really like doing that, so I let Mario run for a little to stop my jump sequence, then simply single jump again to end up at the edge of the platform. While approaching this spot, adjust your camera to get it ready and in position for the upcoming movement. Walk slightly over the edge, then long jump, holding towards the platform ahead on your left analog stick, all while adjusting your camera to face the wall next to you. We set up like this to make the next piece of movement significantly easier as you can actually see what you're doing. Once you land on the floor, I usually single hop to maintain momentum, then turn the corner and initiate a triple jump. Delay for a little bit, then cap dive and dive onto the nut. There is a super fancy strat here where you can spin pound the nut, then use an up throw to cancel your spin pound, but honestly, buffering a spin on this nut has always felt impossible as hell for me, so I can't recommend it in good faith. So instead, once you land, simply jump and ground pound. Then once you've broken open the nut, press Y to dive and bonk into the back wall, allowing you to quickly grab the moon. Once collected, cap dive and dive towards the wall on your right. Then once you land on this curved section, roll boost, and as you land on the floor, I like to jump again to maintain momentum, but you can obviously just run around the corner if you wish. Then long jump forward towards the edge of the platform you're on. The long jump should put you right at the very edge, more or less, so simply walk slightly over the edge, then jump. Delay slightly, then cap throw towards the railing and dive. Long jump off the ramp and get ready to get hacked. The following FRS movement is one of those strats that you have to kind of practice semi-occasionally, or for some unknown reason, you'll just fail it forever. As soon as you land from the long jump, utilizing some short hops, initiate a triple jump. Once again, with the final jump, in the sequence being off of the railing, then doing the normal FRS movement you're probably already doing. Delay the jump, cap dive, and dive onto the next platform. As soon as you land, long jump, then begin a triple jump. With your last jump in the sequence, being off this raised step, let this triple jump ride out a little bit before finally cap diving and diving onto these floating platforms. You shouldn't have to cap throw here. Then simply jump and dive up top, buffer a spin pound during the dive, and instantly spin pound to break the nut. Don't adjust the camera here. You want it facing the way it's already facing to save time. Once you've jumped up and collected the moon, dive and reset the camera with a bumper button. As soon as you land on the floating platform, shake to input a roll boost, and begin to fall through the air. Throw Cappy forward as soon as you can, and dive straight away. Roll boost twice straight ahead, then hold right on your analog stick to push into this switch platform to turn the corner before beginning to roll boost again so you can roll boost off the edge. Fall through the air before cap diving and diving onto the tower platform at the last second. Then as soon as you touch the floor, throw Cappy while holding left on the analog stick to continue your momentum and enter the tower. Once you've entered the tower, jump and instantly throw Cappy to the left then dive. Press and hold B to get a max height cabby return jump. Delay ever so slightly, then cap dive and dive up onto the platform with the uproot. Roll boost towards the uproot, then roll cancel into it, throw out cappy again to instantly capture it. Using the same strat I laid out previously in the video, boost off the spawning platform in an attempt to get speeding up boy, then land on top of these blocks. Then turn towards the right, jump up, and activate the flower road. If you have both versions of speedy nut boy, you can actually hop your way towards the next nut moon, basically on the very edge of the flower road's hitbox, but unless you're some kind of Tyrone level god, you're unlikely to have speedy nut boy here all that often, so simply run up towards the nut, then press Y and shake to uproot into it to break it. After collecting the moon, begin walking towards the camera, and just as you're about to walk over the edge, input a shake so the uproot begins boosting up, then begin walking over the edge. You'll notice the uproot move upwards instead of falling down. Once it's reached its max height, which is quite quickly, hold up on your analog stick and let go of the Y button to release the uproot and jump up top. Once you land up top, instantly press Y and input a shake. Once you're at the peak of the uproot's boost, let go of Y and uncapture the onion boy, then dive into the moon. Once the moon is collected, simply turn around and instantly dive towards the door, then roll boost out of the tower. As you exit the tower, buffer a spin pound and spin pound towards this little gap in the cage. Then while you're rolling, buffer another spin. As you reach the end of the roll, press the B button to spin jump up in the air and maneuver your way onto the little platform so you can press the trigger button while holding down right to spin pound off it. Press a bumper button to swing the camera around so you can see what you're doing, then vector your way to either Torkatoo or this robot so you can bounce off them to negate the fall stun animation. You can technically buffer a jump here, so that you don't have to bounce off of either of them, which would theoretically be better, but there are just times where sometimes it straight up won't work for no apparent reason, and honestly, there isn't much point taking that risk. So once you've bounced off one of them, there isn't really one specific piece of movement here that works every single time, as your position and speed will vary almost every single time just by the nature of this movement. So all I can really say here is focus on what would be the most optimal. Try to minimize the amount of cap dives you have to do, but also don't make stupid decisions in an effort to not use them altogether. Then, once you've arrived around this corner, begin a triple jump. Then at the peak of this triple, aim into the wall to your left to wall jump, then hold forwards towards the platform and input an up throw. Shake again so Cappy begins to home in and instantly dive. If done correctly, just as you land, Cappy should have returned to you, so you can instantly jump up with a Cappy return jump, aim towards the wall, then Cappy stall against the wall to do damage to the nut, then wall jump and throw Cappy again. Grab the moon, then instantly throw Cappy to the left and dive. Roll boost once and begin to buffer a spin pound. Your roll should stop just past the corner, which lets you perfectly set up a spin pound to head towards flooded pipeways. Then just continue roll boosting, avoiding the onion boys, and follow this line along the ground with your last roll boost happening past this area here so you land directly in front of the pipe in the water. Once you're falling over the edge, let go of the analog stick so when Mario hits the water, he immediately begins sinking, then just swim into the pipe. Now, to cut down on the length of this video a tiny bit, we won't be going over flooded pipeways again as I already have a video on it, but basically do what is explained in that video, then warp to the Odyssey and you're out of Water Kingdom. That's it for the main route. You made it out of the literal hell of early game, but there is something else we mentioned a little earlier that we still have to go over. There is a backup route that is quite useful if you mess up Nutclip and still want to keep going. I do want to preface this part of the video and say I've never personally used this route in any runs. I'm at a point where if I miss Nutclip, the run is kind of boned, but it can be useful for people that just don't want to give up on their run yet and squeeze a little more life out of it. As I don't know amazingly optimal movement for this route, take what I say with a grain of salt. It's not going to be perfect, and I'm not going to go incredibly in depth on the movement here as I don't totally know it again, but let's try to dive in. In my example here, I'm going to assume you already have Tree Moon and you just missed Nutclip. Turn around and dive, then roll boost. Begin a double jump as you turn the corner, then dive and jump into a cap dive to get up to this corner of the floor. Then you can either spin pound or turn Mario around and backflip, then push Mario towards the above floor before cap diving and diving up top. Roll boost towards this back section of the wall before spin pounding and cap diving towards this little cutout in the wall. There's a little platform here Mario can stand on. Once you're on it, you can backflip away from the wall and cap dive towards the right, wall jump, then cap throw and dive to end up top, similar to where you would normally come out of Nutclip movement. Then things are essentially exactly the same as the normal route until you come out of the red maze. Once you come out and head towards the poison area, once you land, Morbius twice, then begin a triple jump sequence, with the final jump in the triple being off, or just before this poison. If you choose to poison triple and were wondering how it works, it's just another buffered jump. Pressing the jump button just before hitting the poison will allow Mario to triple jump off it. You have to be in a certain spot for it to work, but it is possible and looks extra spicy, but again, isn't totally necessary. Then, grab the moon around the corner as normal, and as you're returning after you turn the corner, long jump, then as you run over the edge of the platform, single jump, then dive into the gap of the railing, before finally roll boosting and long jumping into the moon. Then just do the original way of doing FRS and continue the route like normal. And that's it. You've backed up Wooded Kingdom. But gamers, that's it. We made it through Wooded Kingdom and 6 pages of written script. Thank you for watching this video. But we're not quite done yet. If you aren't already, and you want to join the community, have some conversation with some gamers, see some cat pics, consider joining the Discord. The link is in the description. It would mean a lot to me, and my community is very loving and welcoming, and we'd love to see you over there. If you want to interact with that community live, once again, do consider heading on over to my Twitch channel. The link is also in the description. We can chat to me live about Odyssey or whatever else your wild mind wants to talk about. But gamers, I've said enough words today. Thank you so much for watching, for listening, for dealing with my weird plugs. I'll see you guys in the next video. I appreciate you.